Welcome back to the vote, second half. I'm with Patrick Timms, deputy editor of the Wolves of Westminster blog. We're going to be talking about the police and crime bill, and there's still been a lot of protests about that, and in a way, kind of rightly so, because there are some contentious elements to it where the police can kind of, you know, dictate how noisy a protest is going to be, which actually is in the bill. I was reading the legislation itself just the other day, so you can understand why people are concerned about it, can't you? In a way, yeah.
Their argument is that, because if you look at the parts of the bill that are talking about saying, you know, it mustn't be overly inconvenient, it mustn't cause a nuisance in terms of whether it's too noisy or whether people feel distressed or anything like that. Now, there are some people, of course, saying, well, do you know what, that's supposed to be the point of a protest. Whereas other people say, well, no, you should do it more peacefully. Now, I think from the government's point of view, they haven't officially said this, but I think all sort of commentators are making the assumption that this is a direct response to the action that was taken last year by the Black Lives Matter movement, by Extinction Rebellion, when they were able to. They're obviously a lot less active last year. The pulling down of statues, the rioting in the streets, the general bad behaviour. And of course, I am aware of some people saying, well, why didn't they bring this in at the time then? Why now? And I think what those people perhaps haven't quite understood is that A, the government was quite busy last year, and B, it takes a while for sentiment to percolate through and then for legislation to be drafted and put through the Commons. And of course, there were large periods last year also, just to finish up, where it was very, very difficult to actually have parliamentary business going on virtually in the House, or rather very much not in the House, as the case may be. So now we have this government's response to some of the very bad behaviour last year and running through to this year. This is what it entails. It is designed to ensure that if people are going to have protests, and they can't cause too much of a problem, which of course, for the kinds of people who like protesting, is that's rather inconvenient. And there have been many protests under the moniker of Kill the Bill, as it's known, where people are trying to get it sort of shut down or stopped. I find it unlikely that they're going to succeed, but of course they, you know, being, yeah, perhaps they're wishing to enjoy the last few months of when they're able to protest the old-fashioned way.